my humble obeisances in the Lotus Feet of my Paramaradhatam Guru Pad Padma Yukta Nidhaya Pravishtum Usna Pashishma Bhakti Prakhyam Kusam Usna. And in the Lotus Feet of my Shiksha Guru Om Vishnu Pashishma Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj. Today, just now, a question came in mind that there are two persons, both are devotees. One wants to be in the association of devotees, always doing Nam Sankirtan, wanting to remember with them. And another devotee, he wants to be very interior, where anyone cannot go, making a hut there very easily, alone. He can chant and remember, but alone. What is better? To whom you prefer for your bhajan sadhana, especially in Kali Yuga?
First of all.
Oh, I'm not asking all, but I will point out to whom. Oh, a very senior devotee is here. Oh, and he is even bound to go. Perhaps he was initiated by Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. Yes. I want to hear his opinion, what he prefers better. Oh, you should stand up and what is better for us to do?
It is much better in the association of devotees. The scripture said even 1/11 of a second of association of devotees is worth more than many, many different lives of experience in this material world. And especially for development of Krishna consciousness, there's nothing better than Sadhusanga. Alone in the forest, you're still with your mind. My mind can do so much better.
Thank you. Very good. Chaudhari Rishi. Oh. He was like a devotee too, not only yogi. And he wanted to be alone in Vrindavan and doing austerities in the river Jamuna. Very cold, very hot, no hot. But when a lust came in his heart, who saved him? He was not saved. What became? No. By his influence of his austerity, he divided him, he manifested him in how many forms? 50 forms. And he married young daughters of, very beautiful daughter of king, Mandhava. And thus he enjoyed with them 10,000 years, more than that. So I think, if any high class of devotees he may be, but he should not think that, oh, I will go on the bank of Ganges or Jamuna, in Gangotri Himalaya, very far, very big scenery, topmost scenery. Ganga is
flowing.
What?
Flowing.
Coming from high place there, up from Gomukhi. And very beautiful scenery. So I will make a hut there. No one will be too disturbed. Oh, no person will be. But this calm day, very crooked calm, will not give up. He will follow there even. So we should try to be very, very careful. In Kaljuga, with the devotees, they will always like the God. Even they are more Kanishtha Adhikari than us, no, but they will God. So we should try. Realize these things, helping the devotees and Guru there, Vaishnava, in the preaching and chanting name always. Preaching is one of the part of practice and bhakti yoga. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself here too. That oh, Namacharya Dathatu, you are Namir Acharya. Those who only preach, they are karmi. Those who preach Hare Krishna movement or anything, but not practicing themselves, they are like karmis. They will have to enjoy their past impressions and these impressions. And those who are not practicing, those who are only practicing, not preaching, they are something, but they are. And those who are chanting, remembering, that's all time, also preaching. Like you, Haridas Thakur, you are one of your thoughts. We are all like you. So we should try to. But follow all the now we should come to here. Last, go Premanandare. I told this, God knows that any rare knows.
God knows some rare disciple.
We explain the Gopi modes told by Gopi Srimati Radhika to Krishna. Krishna heard and he began to be. Then he began to reply something. If anyone wants to advance in bhakti, they should try to follow this thing. Only this is not. Oh, this will not do anything. Understand? Negative aspect. They cannot help so much. If positive is there, then they are. But positive also must be with negative. Otherwise, he cannot go on. So, what is told? We cannot live without you, maintain our life. So better you should come to Vrindavan, and that Vrindavan is our home. And if you are not coming, you should see that. All Vrindavan will be lifeless. All will be gone. Suniya Radhika Vani, ब्रज प्रेम मन भावे बैक विथ देह मन पैथेटिक वर्ड्स ऑफ गोपी दी ऑफ And then he became restless. And he could not control himself. And then he thought that I cannot repay this past. And then he began pacified. All Brajvasi, especially Srimati Radhika. Ram Priya. My most beloved. I'm telling truth to you with my pure heart. Tuma Sabar Smarani. Juru Bhai Gat Vidhi. Murduk na jane konu. I'm in Dwarka. My this body is there, but my heart is there with you in Vrindavan. Always restless, feeling so much separation. Day and night, I'm restless so much. There is none to whom I should reveal my heart. And that is why I sent Uddhav to go to Raja and to be admitted in the school of Guru, to learn something, what is called praying. And if he will be expert, then he will return. Then I met him and he will realize my heart, how I am feeling. To whom I can. I cannot tell to Uddhav even, to Rukmini Saptamama, I cannot. But always, repenting, waiting and waiting. Vrajavasi Jata Jan, Mata Pita Sakhadam, Sabemor Hoye Pransam, all the Vrajavasi, Mata Pita, Sakhagan, Mata Father, Mother, and my all covered boys, my friends, Sakha, these are like equal to my life. Pran means life. Tarmadhya Gopigan, among them, oh Gopi, all the Gopis are like My Sakshat Jivan. Direct? Life here. And you Srimati Radhika, more Jivan e Jivan, life of life. Tuma Sabat Premanse, Amake Parila, Vashe. I'm controlled by your love and affection. Now I am only yours and yours. I am your eternal servant. So, this what creator of this world, the creator of this world. Oh, he is very cruel, fault. He has taken me from very far away from you. I was vivastha. I was helpless. Like we all are helpless to God. Helpless to go here and there. Helpless in any way. So Krishna is telling that. Now I am helpless. You are also helpless. That creator possibly has taken me very far away from you and from my birthplace, Gokul Vrindavan. And it is my dubbha, it is my misfortune. Priya, Priya Sangahina. Priya, Priya, Priya Sangamina. Nahi jiye e satya vasa. It is true that most beloved, she cannot maintain her life without Priyatam.
When a woman is separated from the man she loves, or a man is separated from his beloved woman, neither of them can live. It is a fact that they live only for one another. For if one dies and the other hears of it, he or she will die also.
He's not telling about Western people. Never, never. He's telling of Vedic culture, women, like gopis and here, or they will be very happy. He should give some money, oh that's all I am giving. But in India, this air is also entering in India also, so much. Delhi, Bombay, Madras, Calcutta, it has reached, not in very village area, but there. I request you to not involve in this. Very careful, very careful. But I think that sometimes you are helpless to do it. You are bound to do it. But if you will call, he will request your Guru and Vaishnava and Krishna and Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Sarup Dhamma, what they can say. Only this. Otherwise, you cannot be saved. So it is true that a woman without his beloved, she cannot maintain his life, her life. And also that beloved, who cannot maintain his life without his priya. Mor dasa sone jabe, ei, tar ei dasa hobe, ei bhaye dui rakhe pran. Common things. They are telling for Radhika, not for other. That woman separated by his beloved. Why he don't die? That if I will die, then my beloved will fade bitter and give me a joy. So I should. For his beloved, that he will suffer so much. So I don't want to give him any suffering. And also that beloved person, he thinks that if he will die for separation, she will be later and she will be so suffering. So both they don't want to die. Sheshati Premavati. Premavan Sheipati. Yoga je panche yahi. So this is important. This is theory. Sheshati Premavati. Mali man sis lady is there. This lady is that lady who has so much high class of love and affection for his beloved. That in Vyog even, in separation also, always she thinks welfare of his beloved. Always and always. Like Ram, in any case, she told Sita, for whole life you I am giving up. And he sent her to the forest forever, her whole life. Sita was separated. She was weeping bitterly. And that time she was pregnant. Otherwise she may have died. After that, law course, she took two sons. But what became? She was always from forest. Though she was suffering so much from his husband. But always she used to tell him to have this thing that Ram should be happy. He had done wrong or right. I am not going to do this. I want that. Anywhere he will be. Anyhow, but he should be. And Ram? Ram was in his big palace, royal palace. He left out his pillows and palanka and everything. He became renounced there, sleeping on the ground, on a mat, like Sita did, not taking any delicious food. Some throws to live, to maintain his life, like Sita he was. And always what doing? Feeling this affliction. She was unable to survive him. And that is why he used to make some sacrifices here. And making a statue of Sita. So, lady, just lady, who has love and affection for his beloved, he always thinks the welfare of his beloved. Even anything has been created, very wrong thing for her, or created by his beloved, no harm. And same thing, her beloved should think about his wife, for his most beloved. Nagone apano dukh banche nije priya se. Priya janas. Sei koi mile asira. They don't look after their own happiness or suffering. Always they think the suffering and the happiness of their love. We should try to take here what is instruction. If you want to be like that, first you should try to begin this thing for your good. Understand? If you is very high class of devotees, he has love and affection for you. And he is taking you to Krishna consciousness more and more. He also gives you more attention to your duty. Don't look your sufferings, your own happiness. How I can please? How I can please? If there is not in this thing in disciples, they are bound to give up this way. So first it will come in disciples this mode to Gurudev. Like Srimad Bhagavati has been told, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Svaranam, Bhav, Sivanam, Vachanam, Bandhanam, Dasanam, Satkamatam, Vidhi. Iti Pulsarthita. Bhaktischei Navalakhana. Create Bhagavat Bhaktha. First, give yourself in the lotus feet of O Krishna. Just would offer yourself, but there are two Krishna. No? First is Guru Bhagavan, and then Krishna Bhagavan. This is the Ashram. First, come to Ashram Bhagavan. He is Guru. He is perfect, he. And he has sent about all the qualities told in Srimad Bhagavatam and Upanishad. You should have a strong faith on him and try to please him first, and then this Guru, with his own power, he will transfer to you these things to Krishna and to Radha and Mahaprabhu. It's so far. So, Punsarpita, first you should surrender yourself in the Lord's feet. Not only surrender, always engage your heart and mind on all your senses to please your Guru. How you can please? If you are chanting his name, always only glorifying Bhakti, Krishna, Mahaprabhu, preaching and practicing Bhakti Yoga. Like Rupa Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam. It has told formally Rupa Goswami, there was so many doing, but he gave an example. He knew what he did. What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted, and from what reason he has descended to this world. He made so many books, Bhakti Swami Sindhu, Kutumalini, many and so on. And he established Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how to please Chaitanya. So be so proud. You are assembled here only for this, to be inspired and to do. Not only recreation, for recreation you are not called. Not only to follow or to make a drama play. We have not come to play a drama. Really, to know the process, how we can please Radha Krishna Mahaprabhu. First, to Guru Dev, Vaishnava. So here, Nagane Apane Du, Panche Priya Janasu, Sei Mai Dule Asu. If they are going like so, then they can be together. Again, he is giving consolation, pacifying the world. Certainly, they will be together. Rakhite Tumar Jivan, Sevi Ami Narayan, Tasakthe Asi Nikiniti, Tumasa Nikidakari, Unajayi Jadutu, Tahatumi Manuha Moroshkurti. What is maybe?
Krishna is speaking, Srimati Radhika. You are my most Radhika. Krishna is answering. Yes. You are my most dear. And I know that in my absence, you cannot live for a moment. Just to keep you living, I worship Lord Narayan. By his merciful potency, I come to Vrindavan every day to enjoy pastimes with you. I then return to Dwarka Dham. Thus you can always feel my presence here in Vrindavan.
We should try to realize. Have you any respect and this Madhya Bhav? My next to Gurudev, our devotees are all. If not, then minus everything. Nothing. You cannot do anything. Yes. Oh, my-ness. Oh, good is mine. I've left my father, mother, sisters, whole family. For whom? For Krishna. And this, my Gurudev can give Krishna. Now he is my everything. So much attachment with Gurudev will come. If there is no attachment for Gurudev, but there are so much attachment for all, but not to Gurudev. Then what is this? This is something wrong. So please, my Gurudev, I can serve all. But I am not going to please all that, all will be very happy to serve my Guru. Understand?
Yes.
No? Very good thing. Again, I am repeating. To please Gurudev, I am going to serve all. This is one way. No? And to please all to serve Gurudev is another thing. Understand this thing? Oh, you? What I am telling?
Gurudev is saying that there are two conceptions. The first conception is, I am going to serve all the devotees. Why? To please my Gurudev. This is one conception. Then the other conception is, I am going to please all the devotees to serve my Gurudev. So one is, I am going to serve all the devotees to please my Gurudev. The other one is, I am going to please all devotees to serve my Gurudev.
For this motive should be that far. I want to please my Guru, not to please all. And to please all, I am going to with all. Because all will be very happy if I am pleasing them. I am serving my Guru. Understand? This thing is so secondary. No attachment to Guru. So, we should try to, whatever we do, to please, not to all. You cannot please all. Never and never, you should know. You cannot. Better to please. Jasya prasada bhagavat prasado. Jasya prasada nagati kutoki. Dhyayam tu manutasya jasasti shanyam vande guroshi charanaravinda vande guroshi charanaravinda. All the easy numbers. In this life, in practicing of bhakti yoga, we should always try to please your Gurudev. If he is happy, please, all will be pleased. Even not please, no harm. If Krishna is somewhat angry to me, no harm, oh Gurudev will save me. But if Guru is unhappy, oh Krishna cannot save. He will tell that you should go there. He told to Durvasa, what all? This is about Ambarish. I cannot do anything. So this. Now, to please you, to that you should not die in my separation. And what? I am worshipping Narayan. And by his worshipful potency, I can go to Vrindavan, Braja. From where? And I meet you with my Pitamba, I wash your mouth. I meet you, I embrace you. But you think that, oh, Krishna is God. How can I? Oh, I was dreaming perhaps like this. Or any spooky was. What is God is spooky? Momentary vision, that, oh, this seeing a tamal tree, at once he thought, oh, Krishna has come. So, this is called this spurti, momentary. So, you think that, oh, Krishna has not come. It is our momentary vision, but it is not true. Always I go to you and meet and embrace you. And so much playing with you, and then I come. Again I go. When you are in so much separation, I always do like this. Mor bhagya, mo vishaye, tumar je prem, se prem param prabhav. Oh, you are very lucky. Very, very lucky. That the love and affection to me, in me, is so, so high class, so powerful, that it attracts me and daily I go and meet you. What do you think that I am coming in for momentary vision? But it is so I go. I think that this love and affection high class, very soon, I will come. Prakatayamani? Oh, all will see, and I will come. Oh, I've killed the so many kings and so many powerful demons who were fighting from towards Kansa, for Kansa Deva. I've killed so many. But still there are some. You can tell that it, just now you should come. But I know that if I am in Braja, then demons will think, especially Jarasandha and all others. They will think, oh, Krishna is here in Vrindavan. And his father mother is Nanda and Yashoda. His friends are all. So we should try to kill them. Here is no fort, no army, nothing he has to fight. So, knowingly I am here, in fort of Dwarka, everywhere water, and so much armies, all are there. But he, against party will know that I am in a Vrindavan. I cannot say. So I am not coming just now. I will kill all others. There are so many more. And then, Acharan, Sei Satrugan Haite Prajijana Rati Rahe Rahi Rati. Oh. And that is why that Prajbasi should not be disturbed. They should not suffer. I am in Dwarka, but how I am? Udasin haiya. What is the meaning of Udasin? Huh? So I am indifferent, not far Braja. I am different from this kingdom. The associates here, so many queens, so many sons and daughters. For them I am renounced, I have no attachment with them. I am always suffering for Vrajavasi. Jeva Itri Putra Dhane, Kali Rajya Arohane. I have married so many princes and I am like a king here. only to satisfy Jadugar. Why? That my father's friend. My father is Nand Baba. And all the Jadvansi are friend of Nand Baba, Vasudev and all. And that is why to satisfy, I am here. Otherwise I have gone to Vrindavan. Tumar e prem gun kare ama akarshan anibe ama das gan din das abhishe. Kuna ashe Vrindavane prajubadhu tumar shanthi vidashi padajana. So very soon, in 5 days or 10 days, I will go quickly, I will kill all the demons. And then very soon I am coming, you should think that I have come. Eto kahi, eto tare kahi Krishna, vaje jai te sa Krishna, e slok kodi sunai. Then he told a slok. To go kis, mai bhakti hi bhutanam, amitvaya kalpate dishtyajat asmat sriho, bhavati nang madasana. He told that. Oh, this is in Srimad Bhagavatam. My bhakti hi putana amrit paya kalpate. Oh, you should tell me.
This is Srimad Bhagavatam 10.82.45. Mahi bhakti hi putana amrit paya kalpate. Ista yada sinvat sneho bhavati nam madapanaha. Lord Sri Krishna said, devotional service unto me is the only way to attain me. My dear gopis, whatever love and affection you have attained for me by good fortune is the only reason for my returning to you.
Here, my bhakti hi tu bhutana amrit paya. The bhakti to Krishna, to me, is like amrita, nectar. But your bhakti from sadhana bhakti, it has gone up, anartha, has gone all anartha, nishtha, ruchi, asakti, bhav, prem, then sneha, sneha of two kinds, or he will describe. Dhrita sneha, madhu sneha. And then from there, man. Man also two. Pranay is also two kinds. And then bhav. Rag. Then anurag. Bhav. So you have all these things. Not only bhakti. Bhakti here is sadhana bhakti. Sadhana bhakti is like nectar to all. And this, very rare in this world, especially not in this world, sneha man prane raghunta. These are improved in heart. If every good life is, you should think that he can very big. And this is the reason I cannot control myself. I am bound to follow all the examples. So there will be no delay. Apivata madhukurya arti putra guna. Go on. No. Apivata madhukurya arti putra guna. Smartsha pitri gahan bandhu sumasya. Katamapi kinkri nam granite bhujamal bandhu subandha. Oh, Srimati Radhika, in this love and affection, she is remembering Krishna so in high way, weeping and asking to bamboo beings. Oh, Krishna is coming? Where coming? Oh, he is in the way from here. Can you tell how is he? Whether he remembers his friends, Raja, whom? His father, mother. And even he remembers us and me. That is very not so much intelligent like you are. Or this garland is not so good as gopi used to make. Anyhow, Krishna is remembering us and telling this, he remembers this and he can sense it. So these are the love and affection for Krishna. To have these kinds of love and affection, we should from beginning try to accept the bhakti. And from bhakti, gradually, ādau sattā tata sādhu saṅkha tato anvattam bhakti, and life you should follow. Don't see here and there, whatever maya will affect you. Go premānanti. Now there is
who went to Dwarka. He doesn't see Jagannath like we see him. Yes. So how is it that he's weeping and fainting and singing Jagagaga Jagagaga to Jagannath?
Because he is in Dwarka. He is not in Vrindavan. So his separation would be not high so much. So much high. He thinks at that time, for Krishna, and for Mahaprabhu, we can see here. Sometimes he uses, but when seeing, oh, say to Parana, same fancy, Vajendranandan Shyam Sundar, always. And always he was feeling separation. How? Like Srimati Radhika, when she met with Uddhav, used to meet. And feeling so much separation. And that mood of Radhika used to come in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and this Jagannath, not Jagannath. He used to see Bansi, Gormukha, in full, like Vajendranam Darsha. You should try to be prepared for your drama.
Hare Maharadya Guru Pad Padma Aung Vishnu Pasishmat Bhakti Prajnan Kesava Goswami. And then same to my Siksha Guru Aung Vishnu Pad Shishmat Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj. I'm very happy that our core festival was wonderful. And our classes also here, so good. Everywhere I cut the arguments of opposite parties, Mayabadi here and there, and telling so much about how to practice or how to follow Rupa Goswami's instructions and the life of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Haridas Thakur and Prahlad Maharaj everywhere. But here it was called festival. So I was bound to speak something. Otherwise, anyone cannot have any idea about this. So maintain and to keep it, that they should know also something. I know that all cannot understand all high class of ideas. But I know that there are few, rares, they can understand. They can have any line for this. For future they will be more okay. That is why I decided to speak and explain something about God festival. But we should know Only hearing will not do. We should try to be Bansi of Krishna, Venu of Krishna, Lute of Krishna. Nothing there inside. Whole there. So who are hearing? Audience and disciples. Always to try to be that float, nothing inside. They should try to take the air, vibration of their Gurudev. Because he has taken his Guru Parampara, this thing, and from Radha Krishna and Mahaprabhu. So we should try to know this and become. We should try to follow and glorify the words of Guru. Reconcile everything. Tadviddhi panipatena pariprasnena sevaya. Otherwise, by your escapulation, you may be so much learned person, but it will not help you, but it will what? Betray you. So you should. And then everything you will realize, coming automate. Yesterday I glorified Gopis, Prem. No? Tam Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. But before this subject, I want to give my blessings and my thanks so much who managed all these things, especially Rath Yatra festival. Very good. And something, credit goes to Sripad Ashram Maharaj. And that is why I gave him sannyas. He is qualified person for this. He can do more. I hope in future he will do so many things to keep our lines. So my heartly blessing to him and his who helped him. All the boys of our Birmingham Gaudiya Math, especially that Prabhu, Arjuna, and Mishra and all other. I cannot take their names, but they should know their names. And also that Prabhu, what name?
Vidur Prabhu.
Vidur Prabhu. Yeah. Jamun Jivan. Where is Jamun Jivan?
Jamun Jivan, in fact, sir.
Where?
Yeah.
Oh, he helped? Very good. Thank you. I was eagerly waiting for him that when Jamun Jivan Prabhu will come. He made himself gentle, bigger. Oh, very good.
Other devotee behind him, Jivan. Prabhu, come forward.
Oh, he is Lavang Prabhu. He also helped.
He made big Jagannath.
Oh, big Jagannath.
He made.
So much thanks to you for that. And thanks and my heartly blessing to all those who are assembled here and have taken part in this court festival and also in our classes. Thank you. What are you doing? I'm very happy. Very happy. And try to follow something what we are giving. And in future you should be more qualified. And thus your worldly desire will go. But be careful. Don't go to fire. We should be careful for fire and ease you in favorable things. But don't go and don't burn in that fire. I'm giving some hints. We should try to follow. Now I'm coming to my subject. Oh, you should listen very patiently. Very patiently. Yesterday, in my class, I told remorse of gopis, and after that, answer of Krishna. We can read, but to go this so deep, it is very rare. I give an example of a sloka of Krishna Karanamrita or where Radha Rasadhani. Jam Brahma Rudra Sukanarada Bhisya Mukhai Ra Lakshitona Sahasa Purushasya Tasya Satyam Tang Radhika. And I explain something. And after me, Tirth Maharaj also explained something. What you explained, please? What you explained for this sloka? Sukha Narada Bhishma Mukhai Sanatan Sanak Sanandan. What you told in your class? Oh, first you should laugh and then tell. Better. Not so much what you explained.
Yo Brahma Rudra Sukha Narada Bhishma Mukhai. Ralachito Nasahasa Purushasatas. So they called Mahajan, Brahma, Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Narada Rishi. Narada,
what you told, you should tell that.
Bhishma Pitamaha, they prayed to Sri Radha Govinda, Radha Krishna. They had opulence mood, so they could not understand what is the sweetness mood in Radha Krishna's pastimes, leelas. Sweetness Leela. They are looking also, they are opulence mood and opulence bhav. So they are told, Radha Krishna's Leela is so deep Leela. And so very rare person they are understand. So everybody they could not understand. So yo Brahma Rudra Sukha Narada Bhishma Mukhai Ralakhito Na Sahasa Purushasatasya Paham Purush, Lila Purushottam, Lord Sri Krishna, so he is coming from Golok Vrindavan and he is playing here. But everybody and no understand Radha Krishna's sweetness, Lila. And Sri Radhika is form of Mahabhava. Sri Krishna always testing Radhika's mood, Radhika's bhava. And he is playing all with Braja Gopis. But what is their mood? In Ratha Yatra festival, so there have Radhika's mood, too much separation mood. So Sri Krishna went Dwarkapuri and he looked Radhika's separation mood. So prem, sneha, man, pranay, rag, anurag, bhav, mahabhav. More than ruda, adhiruda, mohan, madan, madan, ittar, etc. But when Sri Krishna played in Vrindavan, in Ras Leela, there, so Radhika's bhav, highest bhav is coming, Mahabhav. Then he tested this Mahabhav ras. After then, when he went in Dwarkapuri, then Sri Radhika's separation mood, so highest bhav is coming. So Sri Krishna showed this bhav. Everybody, they looked. What is the gopi's brain and what is the Radhika's mood? And highest bhav. So I am testing this rot, ras. I am giver of full pleasures. So I am giver of devotional fame. So I am not testing. I am not only enjoyer. I am not only sense enjoyer. So I am giver of full pleasures, pure fame. So I am showing this fame and I will test this mood, this bhav. Is that I told? So, Sri Krishna played in Vrindavan. When he is playing in Vrindavan, then stone is melting and water becomes stone. So everything changed, their mood. So all the things changed. And when melting heart, then tears fallen. But when Sri Krishna went in Dwarkapuri, always he is crying for Sri Radhika and all Brajagopi. Then his body is melting. Melting body then becomes Jagannath Baldev Subhadra. So always Sri Krishna is moved Radhika, and Radhika is moved, Radhika is bhav, Radhika is thinking Sri Krishna. So they are moved. So Mahaprabhu become, Sri Krishna become Mahaprabhu, and he is testing this Mahabhavras, only Sri Radhika is Mahabhavras, and when he is testing, sometimes he become like a tortoise. Sometimes he become long,
what
very long.
What you told yesterday in your class, I want to hear that thing. Huh? Yes, only in this sloka. Something different you told. And
so,
what is that?
Mahaprabhu is testing this mode. So, this bhav, this the Ratha Yatra festival, so this is Leela and Ras.
This is
everybody
right.
They could
you
not understand.
Concerning that mode. What
so,
is that?
Jo Brahma Rudra Sukha Narada Bhishma Mukha Ra Lakshito Na Sahasa Purushasatas Brahma Rudra Sukhdev Goswami Narad Rishi and Bhishma Pitamaha.
When?
Bhishma Pitamaha. They prayed this opulence mood. They have
oh,
no
you have to.
Fitness.
Yes, yes, yes. No. Okay, okay, very good, very good. Very good thing. Oh, I want to say that ya Brahma Rudra Sukha Narada Bhishya Mukhai Alakshito Narasasa Purushasya Tasya. High class they devotee are Brahma, Sukh, Narada. Even Sanak Sanandan Sanatan Sanat Kumar Bhisham Pitama, all are high class of devotees. More than or 12 Mahajan, more than them. They are prominent than them. How? But they cannot control Krishna. This is the thing. But only Shurnama Nanta Shakti, the lotus feet of Radhika's dust is so powerful that it can very easily can control Krishna. Krishna may be happy. He is satisfied with the love and affection of what I told these names. But he was not controlled, not even a part, fraction even. But if anyone wants to control, then what they should do? So try to collect or like to search what? Feet dust, one even feet dust particle. What is that? The guidance of gopis like Roop, Sanatan, Raghunath Das Goswami. They were Roop Manjari, Rati Lavan Manjari. If Krishna will know that, oh, these are the best servants of Radhika, then what Krishna will do? At once he will be controlled. Otherwise anyone cannot control. So be a particle of the lotus feet of Radhika. Oh, we should try to search that thing. One thing more. What the names have been told. The Brahma. Brahma. He was in Vrindavan. He has seen the pastimes of Krishna. And personally he has prayed. Nomidhyate Abhravapushe. And he saw so many pastimes of Krishna in his Brahma body. Oh, Sukha. Sukti is who? A special parrot of Srimati Radhika. always on hand of Radhika, but Radhika is caressing and giving some what thing? And teaching him what? Oh, Krishna, Krishna, Govinda, Brajanath, Prananath, like this, always steady. Always in association of Radha and Krishna. Even in morning Nishanta Lila, she may be there to evoke Krishna and Radhika. This is a very high class of Sukh. And now you know that this Sukh became Sukhdev Goswami. And here it has been told, what? Purushasya tasya. He cannot control Krishna. He can, sir. But Krishna will be only controlled by the parties, member of Srimati Radhika. Not anywhere else. Shuka, Narada. Who is Narada? Narada went to Vrindavan in Gokul even, and he thought that, oh, Krishna has descended to this world, oh, Radhika may be anywhere. And he went to Gokul, Ravel, and he discovered. And after that, he made a very high class of austerities on Narada Kunda, and he became what? Nadi Gopi. Even Narada Gopi cannot control Krishna, it has been told. It may be that Sanak Sanandan Sanatan, they may be bamboo bees, and they have taken darshan of Krishna. It may be. Anyone was telling me. So it may be no harm. Oh, Krishna himself became bamboo bees and went to where? In Nandagaon. And he took darshan of Radhika in Mahabhava. But he could not know how deep is it. No? He could not know. So Krishna being, and he see desires came in his heart. Oh, how has class of this pranay mood of Radhika? And how he stays, and what kinds of happiness comes in the heart of Krishna? He could not realize. Then he went to where? On the bank of Godavari. And he took so many instructions, and he was admitted in that the school of Vishakha, because he is personal secretary, main secretary of Radhika. And then he learned, and then he came and he realized or he enjoyed these three modes. But even what is the mood of Radhika in Mahabhava, Madan, Modan? Krishna cannot go so deep. He has not that thing, because observer is Srimati Radhika, highest. This mood, Sansam Vedda Dasa, never comes in Krishna. Where comes? In Radhika. So the party men, the sakhis of Radhika, oh, they can know all these things somewhat. More better than Krishna. Krishna is what? Akhil Rasami Sindhu. That is object of love. He is not container or his Ashraya Bhaksa. So here it has been told. Even Sanatan, even the four brothers, Narada, being a gopi, Sukhdev Goswami being on her Tibet, they could not. Even Uddhava went to Vrindavan, and he has some association of Vrindavan. But he could not realize what is the mood of gopis, what they think. And that is why he told, Bande Nanda Brijeshtrinam Padaranim Avikshnasa Jasanghari Kuthod Gita Unat Bhuvanatraya. we should be very humble, very humble, hollow, and then go to Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita and pray, and then they will make very easily realize all this is something. So gopi mood are so high. Today is Hera Panchami. What is Hera Panchami? Can you tell something? Or you want? Actually, something. They know all more, but his English is perfect some. That is why I am telling. Tirtha Maharaj, Ban Maharaj, and Madhav Maharaj, they know so much, more than me even. But my language is lame, that is why I am telling him. You can easily know something.
Tasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chukshurun Militam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. In Sri Jagannath Puri, at the time of Rath Yatra festival, Sri Jagannath Dev, he comes out of Sri Mandir, and there's a very nice festival on the chariot coming from Sri Mandir to, that is Nilachal, to Sundarachal, that is Gundicha temple. But then, when Panchami, the fifth day of the moon, comes, on this day there is a festival, is called Hera Panchami. Hera means to see. That is, that before...
To search.
On the day before Rath Yatra festival, then Jagannath Dev, he spoke with Lakshmi Devi. He said, I am going only for one day, 2 days, and I will be back. But Jagannath Dev, he left, and now several days have passed, and still he has not returned. So at that time, Lakshmi Devi, because she is feels that she's being neglected by her beloved, therefore she becomes very angry. And accompanied by her associates, with so much royal opulence, on a very big palanquin, with so many soldiers and servants, and musicians, and Devadasis, the dancing girls. She comes from the Sri Mandir and goes to Gundicha Mandir. On arriving there, then the servants of Lakshmi Devi, they capture the servants of Jagannath Dev. At the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this means Bakrasha Pandit and other associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And they catch them, they bind them, and they make them the butt of so many jokes and abuse also. So this festival was going on every year, but in this particular year, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to Jagannath Puri, Prataparudra Maharaj, he told Kashi Mishra, who is the superintendent of the Jagannath temple, this year I want to make this festival so wonderful that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be astonished. So he opened his treasury and took all the chamaras and fans and all so many cloths and decorations. He said there should be more Mahaprasadam even than at the time of the Rath Yatra festival, the coming of the chariot. There should be more bigger festival even than at that time. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be very, very pleased. So when this festival was going on, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was sitting with Saurabh Damodar Goswami, and they are watching. And Mahaprabhu is laughing so much. And he saw this, and some questions were inspired within his heart. He wanted to hear some very sweet katha from Saurabh Damodar Goswami. So therefore, he asked some questions from Saurabh Damodar. He said to him, "Oh Saurabh Damodar, we know that Jagannath Dev, he's staying in the temple, and he's going to Sundaracha, which is like Vrindavan. So I want to know from you, why is it that Jagannath Dev did not bring Lakshmi Devi with him?" Then Saurabh Damodar, he said, "Actually, Lakshmi Devi, she is not qualified to take part in the pastimes of Krishna and the gopis in Vrindavan. Only the gopis are qualified to assist and serve Krishna in his Vrindavan Leela. So then, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is satisfied with this, but another question arose in his heart. He said, okay, we know that the pastimes of Krishna in Vrindavan, they're all pure. There's no fault in him. So why is Lakshmi Devi so angry? He's not at fault. Why is she becoming angry with him? Then Swami Damodar, he said, this is the nature of a woman, that if they feel that they are neglected, even slightly, only lesh, only little bit of neglect on the part of their beloved, then they become very angry. So then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said, can you tell me something about the different types of jealous anger? So then Swarup Damodar, he began to explain to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu so many moods, how this man, this angry, sulky mood has many, many different varieties according to different types of nayika, that means heroines. So he described what became all the basis and platform of Srila Rupa Goswami's Ujjwala Nilamani, how there are different types of nayakas, Dhira, Adhira, Dhira Dhira, Mugda, Madhya, Pragalba, the queens in Dwarka, the gopis of Vrindavan, and their different varieties of moods and jealous anger towards Krishna. Upon hearing this, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very, very happy. But at that time, we see that Srivas Thakur was also present. And Srivas Thakur, seeing the opulence of the Goddess of Fortune, he was so happy. And he said, he began to make some jokes with Swarup Damodar. Oh, Swarup Damodar, my Lakshmi Devi is so great. Have you seen? She's riding on a palanquin with so much opulence, sitting on a throne. But your gopis, they don't know anything. Only village girls. They have no wealth, no opulence, or anything. They only know milking cows and these things. They are villagers. They only have flowers and fruits and things like this. So then, Swarup Damodar, he said, actually, it is quite the opposite. There is more opulence in Vrindavan. Gopis have more opulence than Lakshmi Devi. But everything is hidden there. He said that in Vrindavan, all the stones and there, what are they? Chintamani. So powerful. They can fulfill all desires. But what are Brijvasis doing? Oh, only making their homes. And gopis are taking this wealth of Vrindavan and making ankle bells. All the cows in Vrindavan, what are they? Come, Denu. They can fulfill any desire whatsoever. But what are Brijvasis taking from them? Only milk. All the trees, they are Kalpa Briksha. They can fulfill all desires. But Brijvasis, what are they taking? Only picking some flowers and some fruits and offering to Krishna. Why? Because all their desires are satisfied. And this lila is Madhurja Lila, sweetness. So all opulence is there in Vrindavan. Don't think that there's no Aishwarya in Vrindavan. In Vrindavan there's more opulence than all material and spiritual worlds and Vaikuntha, Ayodhya, Dwarka, Mathura, everything all put together. More opulence in one dust of Vrindavan. But the prem there is so high that he's covered over. So when Srivas Thakur began to hear this, he became very ecstatic and began to like this, make a noise with his arm. Why? Because previously he was speaking in his mood like Narad Muni. Because Srivas Thakur is Narad.
But if we go Narad of Vaikuntha.
Narad Rishi of Vaikuntha.
There is also Narad of Goloka Vrindavan, but not here. Here is Narad of Vaikuntha or Golok, not of Vrindavan.
Oh, but if we go more deeply, from where has Narad come? Originally, Madhu Mangal. So he's playing like this and joking, and all devotees are very inspired to hear this very deep Rasa Katha. Thank you.
So today is Thera Pancham. But Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami is telling
Chaitanya Gosai Lila Ananta Apar. Last. 14th. Sahasra Badane Jar Nahi Pai Par. Sri Rupa Raghunath Pade Jara Chaitanya Charitamrita Kahe Krishna Das. What Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami has explained in these chapters? He is telling that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, these leelas, pastimes, are ananta and apar. Ananta means
endless.
Unlimited, endless, deepless. Sahasravadan, even Sahasravadan Baladev Prabhu, with his unlimited mouth, in unlimited time, he cannot explain all. How deep is it? No? Even Krishna himself, being ocean of rush. But anyone can easily know something. How? Rupa Raghunath Padijaras. Though has taken shelter in the lotus feet of Rupa and Raghunath, they can very easily have something from this. Otherwise not. Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol, Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol, Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol, Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Bol.